Frank for his debut on Dancing with the Stars. We have your first look at the eagerly awaited finale to the Pirates of the Caribbean saga. Does Adam Sandler have the chops to take on a serious role opposite Don Cheadle?
So you want to be a music star, a familiar refrain, but how do you get started? Aside from auditioning for American Idol, there are ways to get going, and with me in the studio, a real music insider who's an agent, a consultant, and the author of a new book, Artist Development, A Distinctive Guide to the Music Industry's Lost Art. Please welcome Eugene Foley, alias the man with the golden ear. Hi, Eugene.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Why are you called the man with the golden ear?
I think for years being in the business, I've always had a good reputation of spotting great songs, great artists, and the ability to turn average songs into great songs with development.
I tell you, and you've translated that. You've got a lot of successful stars out there. You were telling me that you have a lot of producers, writers that you've linked up with. What kind of supergroups out there?
Our clients have produced and engineered and mixed U2, Dave Matthews, Britney Spears, Whitney Houston, a lot of the big names, Ozzy Osbourne.
That's great. Now, I want to put you to the test, all right, because your book, which I have right here, really details how a lot of up-and-coming groups out there who might be wondering how to get started, trying to find indie labels. We had a group in our backstage studios called The Kin. We're going to listen to them for a minute. They really are great, and they got their start on the internet with a small fan base. Let's listen to The Kin.
Arise, my friend. Your struggle's almost over.
What do you think, though, for up-and-coming bands like this, Eugene, who might be listening to this interview? I mean, what is the best way to go? Is the internet and YouTube a good start for the
music?
Absolutely,
Sarah. Nowadays, the playing field is certainly a little more level. There's opportunities for bands that don't have a large budget with the support of a label. They could still get out there. They could be promoted through, like you said, YouTube, MySpace, a lot of the websites of that nature where they're getting exposure. Fans could hear the music. They could learn about the band. They could join their mailing list. And you could sell with the digital downloads. They could, you know, make a transaction as well.
Can you make it without being part of a major label?
I think to a certain point. I think people who really want to become superstars, it costs millions of dollars to market someone to get to that level. So with that, you're going to need a label for their financial support, their marketing expertise, their retail distribution, all the things that are still important today. Mm-hmm. But I think you could use the internet as a means to get their attention.
Yeah, a good start.
Right, exactly.
I know in the past, tell me about your relationship with Britney Spears and some of your artists.
Well, a couple of my clients have contributed to a few of her records in the studio and like mixers, remixers, that sort of thing. And, you know, they reported back that she's very, very talented and a wonderful person. And I see all these stories on the news. It's a shame to see the trouble she's going to. I hope she could straighten things out.
Yeah, she fell off the path, so to speak. She's in rehab right now. They say she's doing better. What advice, if she were your client, would you give to her to get her career back on track?
I would want her to get the help she would need first just to straighten out her personal life so she was focused and again, maybe take a little time off just to clear her head and then get her right into the studio. Where
really, just jump right back
in. I think that'd be her best bet because also I think she's been getting a lot of negative press, and if you let that stew too long, sometimes with the media, people start turning your back. You start becoming not respected as much or taken seriously. So I think she needs to get into the studio, make a great record, come out with a hot tour, and just show the world that she really is an amazing talent, because she is. She just needs to reestablish that, I think.
Do you think she can make it? That was going to ask you. Has her time, some people say, oh, her time has passed. She's not as cute anymore, blah, blah, blah. Do you think she could turn out another great album?
I think if she puts the right team around her and the right songs and they really market it quickly while she still has the credibility left, yeah. I think she has a shot, because she really is talented. She's not like one of these, you know, pie in the sky, made for TV movie type of artists. You know, she really is good, a great, you know, great singer, great performer. But the window is short in this business, so it has to be soon if it's ever going to happen.
American Idol. Everybody is trying to make it through American Idol. It's a great vehicle, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I think it's an opportunity for an artist to go on and be in front of literally 30 to 40 million people every week. Even the people who don't win. Many people who are second, third, fourth place have gone on to successful careers because it's a tremendous springboard.
Let's take a look at one of the great artists now in American Idol.
Mama may have.
She has a terrific voice. I think her name is Lakeisha. And who knows, even if she doesn't win, she could still cut a great album like Chris Daughtry did. He didn't win the show, and he's doing so well.
No, it's an amazing springboard where 40 million people know your name. Even if you don't win, you're still in a lot of households.
You have a great story about one of your clients. You have some great stories about how he was into a little drug, sex, and rock and roll. Tell me that story.
It was at a major showcase, and there was about seven or eight record company A&R executives watching the performance, and I'm standing there with those folks. During the guitar solo of one of their songs, the singer leaves the stage and standing with all of us. And he's just, you know, bopping the head, enjoying the music. And he's like, wow, what a great band. And I'm like, that's your band. And he didn't even remember. It was like a Jim from Taxi moment, you know? And he ran back on stage. The poor band, they're looking for him. They're looking for him. They're keeping the solo going. Extra bars, extra bars. He comes right back into the next verse. I don't think the audience even realized what happened. It looked like part of the stage, like the setting that he intentionally left. But it was one of those moments. I'm like, this is a huge night. All the big shots are here to see you, and you don't even remember it's your band. It's a classic rock and roll story. Excess.
Well, they're all here. The stories are here in Artist Development, a great book. And thanks. Come back sometime, and let's talk about any new clients you've got and the road to fame if you want to be a musician.
Exactly. I think anyone trying to make it in the business, it's a new business model and new times, and you need to learn that model.
Thanks.
Thank you for that.
Wow, what a great TV show. Oh, wait, right, still got to do this. Still ahead on Backstage. Evanescence is back on top of the Billboard charts. The band talks about their struggle for success. Sylvester Stallone's co-star is speaking out in support of the star after his steroid scandal. But first, Pam Anderson is setting the record straight about reports that she is rekindling her relationship with Tommy Lee. Pam's story, right after the break.